Let's suppose you have a classification task that involves predicting classes that are not the most convenient to present as one-hot labels. For example, the labels come from a taxonomy of some sort. A computer vision algorithm can classify an object as a poodle, while calling it a dog and an animal is also correct. Misclassifying a poodle as a labradoodle is a smaller mistake compared to misclassifying it as a table. This means that we want our loss function to recognize the structure in the labels and not punish all mistakes equally. I will show three examples of hierarchical losses that you might use in a situation like this and discuss their pros and cons. The first loss we will cover is called the flat softmax loss and is computed bottom-up. In this case, the output layer has the same number of neurons as there are leaves in the tree. The neural network outputs logits, which are then transformed into likelihoods using the softmax function. Then we begin to propagate the likelihoods up the tree, assigning each node a likelihood that equals the sum of its children's likelihoods. Notice how they still sum to one at each level. Now let's see the specific form the flat softmax loss function will take, depending on the label we received. If the label is at the lowest level, the loss function has the exact same cross entropy as in any classification task. If the label is only given at the level above, we simply ignore the level below it and compute the cross entropy for the nodes of this level, using the fact that they still conveniently sum to one. This process continues, allowing it to handle labels at any level. Here, we are always technically optimizing for the lowest level of the full hierarchical label. Another possible approach is computing the softmax from the top to the bottom. This is called conditional softmax loss. To compute conditional softmax hierarchical loss for the same graph, the network output layer needs to have the same length as there are nodes in the tree. It was the number of leaves in the flat softmax. Let's temporarily rearrange the logits to preserve the hierarchical structure. Conditional softmax likelihoods are computed top-down, and the root node gets a likelihood of 1. Then, we apply the softmax function for the children of each node. This is somewhat analogous to computing the conditional probability of the child given the parent. The loss function once again resembles the cross-entropy loss computed over all the nodes in the tree. We consider the ground truth label to have a multi-class structure where each level contributes to the resulting loss. As a side bonus, after some simplifications, we arrive at the negative log likelihood loss for the lowest label in the hierarchy. The last loss we will cover is called the softmax margin loss. It starts in a familiar way. As in the previous one, the network's output layer has the same number of neurons as there are nodes in the entire tree. But unlike the previous one, we are not going to do anything with them just now. Let's store the logit tree for future use. Another object we will need is a tree of margins. Let's jump into an example right away. Here is the ground truth label is marked with a yellow box. We define a cost function for each node as the distance required to travel from the ground truth label. Naturally, it's zero for the ground truth itself. We compute this cost or margin for each label. The goal here is to find a cost function that best preserves the structure of your labels in relations to one another. Depending on your task, you might choose a different cost function. Here, for example, we give a zero value to each node that is an ancestor of the ground truth and a positive margin to everything else. In this case, we encourage the network to predict higher likelihoods for the ancestors as well. A cost function can also be more complex, like one that takes into account the number of descendant leaves and the last common ancestor. All in all, this decision will depend on the task you are trying to solve. Let's go back to the distance margin as an example. We will need both logits and margin for the loss function. The first term of the loss function is the negative log likelihood of the ground truth label. Additionally, we also compute the log sum x function with an opposite sign, so it's minimized. You might recognize the log sum x function from its use in certain calculations that require numerical stability. However, here we use it as a smooth approximation of a maximum. By minimizing this term, we in principle push down all the likelihoods, but those with a larger margin will be penalized harder and thus go down faster. This is how our choice of the margin will determine how the output structure is enforced. The small tau term is just here for scaling the margin, as it might have a very different range of values. A cool property of this particular loss is that unlike the first two, it does not imply that the labels are structured as a tree. They can have different relations entirely, and we will still be able to enforce the structure in the loss if we can define a meaningful cost function. While all the presented losses serve the same purpose, the flat softmax is computationally the most efficient while also showing very competitive performance. The softmax margin loss is more complex, but it comes with the benefit of additional flexibility in terms of the output structure. Thanks for watching, and reach out if you have any questions.